Good afternoon and welcome to today's Daily Market Update. My name is James Hughes, Chief Market Analyst at Alpara UK. We're going to look at the major stories moving financial markets so far today. And a lot of those stories are based around a lot of the economic data which is going to be released and has been released so far this morning. Of course, yesterday saw the closure of US markets due to the Labor Day holiday. Today we'll see the reopening of US markets. So with that reopening of the US markets after that long weekend comes slightly more volume and slightly more volatility in some of the major markets, not just equity markets, of course, but in the currency markets as well. Now, looking at the data, today we do see the economic data on the calendar start to ramp up a little bit. It doesn't really get going until the next couple of days. And really this week in terms of economic data gets more and more busy as we move on and, of course, culminates on Friday with those hugely important non-farm payroll figures coming out and the jobs report from the US. Now, this morning we have had some numbers and we had construction PMI numbers come out of the UK this morning. Now, those numbers came in much better than expected. In fact, came in at the highest level since January. Now, that has, to one degree or another, moved markets a little bit. In terms of equity markets, we're trading higher, but not necessarily by too much. But we also seen a move higher in the pound against the US dollar and against the euro as well. Now, that movement in the pound partially down to that number in terms of the PMI. But there's also been more news today. Now, in a couple of weeks, we get the vote on Scottish independence, where those in Scotland go to the polls to vote for an independent Scotland away from the UK. Now, the last month, the vote within this, and we've had a couple of different debates between both sides of the argument over the last couple of months or so. And a month ago, the difference in terms of the poll was 22 points. Now, within that month and a debate later, we have seen that that gap narrow from 22 points to just 6 points. Now, that's having an effect on the pound as well, and that's moving markets a little bit. Now, with that vote coming up in the next couple of weeks on the 18th of September, it's very important that we now start to gauge just where this vote is going. And with it toing and froing as it has been, a move from 22 points to just 6 is a real big move. And there was a couple of months ago, and even a little bit longer than that, really since this story has been coming out, there had been really a real lack of support for this, for what they call the yes vote in Scotland, to vote for independence for Scotland. Now, with that now coming in and it looking a distinct possibility that we could get a very, very close vote when it comes to polling day on the 18th of September, this is going to be more and more important in terms of the pound and in terms of the overall UK equity markets as well. So there's a lot to go in that story still, but some big developments over the last 24 hours in terms of where that vote is going to go. Now, as we move on, there's other things which do affect that and do affect the UK. And the main one of those comes, of course, on Thursday. But tomorrow we have services PMI numbers. We've had the construction, the manufacturing numbers over the last couple of days. Tomorrow we get services. But really the big story is going to be on Thursday for the UK, where we get the Bank of England interest rate decision. Now, we don't necessarily expect any changes. Of course, we've heard over the last couple of months stories from Mark Carney. We've seen the inflation report. We've also seen meeting minutes from the last meeting that showed two members of the committee voted for rate hikes. Now, that with that vote coming in and two members now voting for rate hikes, it's looking like we're almost on a countdown to when these rates do get pushed higher. Now, of course, we don't expect that to be this week, and we don't expect to see any movement in anything in terms of the Bank of England. But what will be interesting, and of course we won't see this on Thursday, we'll have to wait for the minutes to come out, is just if that does increase the number of people that are voting for a rate hike, if it stays the same, or just exactly where those votes go and what the tone of those minutes are. Now, of course, Mark Carney at the Inflation Report told us that we're looking towards those average earnings figures. He wants to make sure people's money that they're earning is going up before they start putting people's mortgage payments up by moving interest rates higher. And of course, you've got the general election coming up in May 2015 as well. So there's a lot going on between now and then in terms of monetary policy. Will there be a change? Will these numbers get any better? If that average earnings numbers start to get better, there'll be real pressure on the Bank of England to raise those rates. But in terms of a political point of view, we won't necessarily want to see those rates raised before that election. I don't see them being raised now before that election. And that really does come from a change from what I thought before. I have really changed my mind on that one. Now, Looking elsewhere, of course, as we said, non-farm payrolls on Friday, but also on Thursday, we've got that ECB rate decision. That's going to be important, and we could, rumblings are that we're going to potentially see another rate cut from the ECB. Just as we get to the to a point where everyone's calling for quantitative easing, we don't expect to see that QE, a round of asset purchasing at this month's meeting, but we expect to see something which almost tells the rest of the world that the ECB, they still have the appetite to act on this incredibly low inflation figure, which is going on in terms of the Eurozone and the stagnant economy that they've got there. And it's interesting, of course, there's calls for QE in the Eurozone just as we run up to the US in October, finishing their round of quantitative easing and pulling out that asset purchasing program, that has been in place for such a long time. There's so many news stories going on this week, and the week gets busier as we go on in terms of the economic calendar, that it's be very important to keep your eye on that calendar and just when these numbers are coming out. For more news and analysis, go to alpari.co.uk/newsroom. Thank you very much for listening. My name's James Hughes, Chief Market Analyst at Alpari UK.